Chevron.
The third type of nutrients are proteins. So what are proteins? Whereas carbohydrates and fats are known as energy giving foods. So these proteins can be called as bodybuilding foods. So children, these proteins can be called as bodybuilding foods. So these proteins are called as bodybuilding foods. Why? Because these proteins are very helpful to our body to grow tall and strong. So these proteins will help our body. So will help our body to grow strong. To help our body to grow tall and strong. To grow tall and strong. And these proteins will help our body to keep our body very fit and strong, and also these proteins will help our body to grow and also to become very strong. That's why these foods are called bodybuilding foods. And what are the examples for the foods having proteins? So which type of foods will contain proteins? So for example, so the food items like meat, so children, meat and fish, and also some nuts like pulses like children, pulses means grains, and pulses and beans and soya beans and egg, milk. So these are some examples for the food items which will give proteins to our body. And also nuts also. So children, if you take nuts, so nuts means, so that means the dry fruits like cashew nuts, peanuts and almonds, walnuts. So some of the nuts, so will give also proteins to our body. So children, so that's why, what are proteins? So proteins are known as bodybuilding foods. So bodybuilding, so we can grow our body and we can build our body by using these proteins. So if we eat the food items having proteins, then our body will grow tall and our body will become strong. So that's why these food items are called as bodybuilding foods. And these proteins will help our body to grow tall and strong. And examples for the food items having proteins are meat, that means like chicken and mutton. So that is called meat, and fish, pulses. So children, pulses means red gram, green gram, yellow gram. So all these pulses contains proteins, and beans, soya beans, eggs, milk, and all the nuts like cashew nuts and peanuts and walnuts, almonds. So all these nuts will give proteins to our body, and these are very helpful to our body to grow strong and to become tall. So that's why children, so these proteins are very essential for the children. So these are very essential to the kids. Essential to kids and children. It means, to kids means the small young babies. So young children. Young children. Kids and young children, because, so children, so if the kids and young children will eat these proteins at the age of their young, that is at the, when they are childhood, so these proteins help their bodies to grow strong and to grow tall. So that's why these proteins are very helpful and very essential for the kids and young children, because at their age, their body should grow. Their body should grow tall and their body should become strong. So that's why these proteins are very helpful and essential to the kids and young children than adults. So if the children and kids does not eat proteins sufficiently, then their body will become weak and their body does not grow properly, and it will
causes malnutrition.
The children. So if you observe some of the children, so they are seen very weak and they are very lean and thin. So why do some children observe very weak and very lean and thin? Because lack of nutrient food. That means the lack of proteins in their food. So some of the poor children does not buy and does not wear this type of costly. That means meat and fish and these nuts and egg milk are very costly and they cannot buy and they cannot bear such large amounts to eat their food. So children, that's why so most of the poor children will see very weak, very thin and very lean because of lack of these proteins in their foods. So that's why children, so all the children and young children and all the kids should eat their proteins to become strong and to grow their body tall and strong. So this is about the proteins. So next, see the next type of nutrients, that are vitamins. So children, the next type of nutrients are the vitamins. These vitamins are called as protective foods. So these vitamins are called as protective foods. So whereas carbohydrates and fats are known as energy giving foods and proteins are known as bodybuilding foods, and whereas vitamins are known as protective foods. So why these vitamins are called as protective foods? That means these vitamins will protect us from many diseases. And so these vitamins are helpful to our body in many ways. So these vitamins are helpful to our body. So children, so these vitamins are very helpful to our body in many ways. And these vitamins will protect our body from the diseases, from various types of diseases. So these substances will protect our body from diseases. So whereas, so most of the diseases will be protected by these vitamins. That's why we should eat that food only which contains vitamins. So if you eat that food which having vitamins, then most of the diseases will not take place and that food will prevent us from most of the diseases. So these vitamins will protect our body from diseases. That's why these vitamins are known as protective foods. So what are the diseases? Generally, these food items protect our body from various diseases like eye diseases, children, eye diseases and skin diseases, and also body aches, different types of body aches, etc. So children, so these vitamins will protect our body from various diseases like eye diseases, skin diseases, body aches, etc. So if you eat that food which have a plenty of vitamins, will protect our body from the diseases. So that's why these food items, so these vitamins are known as protective foods. And what are the examples for the food items having proteins? So which food items gives us proteins? So children, which food items gives us proteins? So which food items we have to eat to get proteins to our body? So most of the vegetables. So children, most of the leafy vegetables and fruits and milk, eggs. So children, vegetable, fruits and milk, eggs and also chicken, that means flesh, that means meat. So and also cereals. So children, cereals. So all these food items gives us vitamins. So that's why children, every day you have to eat a plenty of fruits and plenty of vegetables. So if you eat the vegetables and plenty of fruits in every day, then you will get vitamins to your body, and these vitamins will protect your body from various diseases. So these are another type of nutrients called vitamins. So now let us see the next type of nutrients, that is minerals.